Okay. I gotta tell this story. Quiet down, Nancy. Nancy's... Hang on. I love this song.
There's something you didn't forget. What?
This fucking song. Okay, that's not what I'm talking about. As fine as it would be to have Jack Michaelson singing Nancy Wilson in her hits tonight. Okay, so this fucking story, you're gonna love it. I can't tell the whole thing because options, but I drive from my house all the way to fucking Port Townsend, which, for those of you who know the 101, it goes all the way from Olympia to the fucking end of the earth, right? So I drive up there, and on the way up, I stop at, what am I going to call it? I stop at the Aerie. What the fuck it? I'll just call it the Aerie. It's pretty smoky, but it's the Aerie. Okay. So I stop at the Aerie, and I say hello to an important figure in the world of figures. And I don't want to identify this person, all right? I don't want to piss them off. I already have. That story's so fucking funny. So I stop there, and we commune, and among other things, I leave my weed there. This is important for later. And then I leave in the morning, and I drive out to Port Townsend, and I drive back. And what I forget to do is get gasoline. So because I'm an idiot. I don't do the math right. I don't do the math right, okay? So I need to get gas to go to either either Olympia by way of I-5 to go home, or I have to go across on the ferry. And it's not the teleporting ferry. Oh, no. I can't take the teleporting ferry. I'm not rated. I'm not white enough. Yeah, so. So I drive to Port Townsend, and I figure where I'm going to go, and then I figure, fuck it, I'm just going to go back. And I figure I can stop at the place where I just was to do, among other things, pick up my weed. Fuckers holding my weed hostage. So I get there at like 2 a.m. And the guy lives in a split level. And he's got a stairway that goes up to his back porch. Right? It's nice. And I go up there, and it's 2 a.m. and the lights are off. Of course, the dude is not expecting me. Come to find out, dude doesn't like me that much. Right? I'm not really sure why. I mean, I can speculate, but, you know, whatever. I mean, I'm not real hip to society's ins and outs on a good day. This one's no different. So I get there, and this is what I do because I'm a genius. I walk up there, and I camp out on the back of his porch next to his locked door in a house with all the lights off with a man sleeping alone. Right? And in my lap, I've got nothing but a pack of cigarettes and this. Oops. Hang on. I just froze my phone. What's wrong here? Uh-oh. Well, it doesn't work. Probably for the best. But I'm holding a stun baton, and I fall asleep in a chair, like I'm waiting for me, like if I were laying in wait. I wasn't laying in wait, but I was camped out in a fucking folding chair in the middle of the night with nothing but a stun baton and a pack of natural smearing spirits to keep me company, right? So I wake up covered in dew. And then he opens the door, and he says, he doesn't say anything, he just looks at me and he says, "Please leave."
You need a pee.
Please leave.
3, 2, 1, Jack Austin, astronaut. Exposed to inappropriate levels of solar energy.
Sunlight makes him the world's smartest man.
I know everything!
With a brain, take it out.
Heat Vision, the motorcycle with the mind of Jack's unemployed roommate. Together they run for their lives, blocked at every turn by adventure.
Move up, don't mess around. Move up, you bring me down.
for real.
Jack, I'm Star. I don't know if you can hear me. I gotta drive, so I got issues. Behind closed doors. Well, okay. So here's the. I just left somewhere that I'd never been before, and when I got there, I knocked on the door and said hi. And considering there's time travel involved, I can't say precisely. Like, we've had sex, and we're gonna have it again. Okay. But instead, I drove away somewhere else, and I was doing something, and I'm a little distracted, and like, she's mega hot. I knew that. Okay. But anyway, I didn't think she'd be there. I drove to this place, and I knocked the door, and this fucking bald, hot ass door, and it's like she's surprised. So that I do nonchalant questions, and then I leave, and then I drive like a fucking flying blue thunder on the fucking freeway. I'm followed by a military DEA dude. Probably they're probably okay. If they're not, there's nothing fucking that I do about it, right? So I'm assuming they're okay since they haven't shot me in the back. They got a nice holy shit, they got a transformer. Wow, okay. They either disappeared or they turned into a different profile machine. Yeah, they got some things. So, hi, I'm Jack, I'm a Star. I forgot to tell you, I cracked the case like, right? I know everything's happening. I know what's going down. And I know how to handle it. And so, of course, I'm on my goddamn motorcycle driving like a fat out of hell with fucking Clandos and a black SUV fucking follow me. And the goddamn thing can transform. Tell me I'm fucking try it. You want to fucking stick out a fucking prescription pad? I'll fucking pull back a goddamn paper shredder. Ugh. But more important, new grapefruit. Oh, fuck. So that's good. And now I know old grapefruit. Not busted. I don't think old grapefruit is old and busted. If old grapefruit is old and busted, wouldn't be the first fucking time, right? And then, I don't know who's addicted to fentanyl right now, but I'm not. And I was placed under a 72-hour psychiatric hold, and they did all their tests on me. And they found out, oh, I'm fine. Hey, bro! Did you hear that guy? He just said, I'm cool as fuck. Thanks a lot, I appreciate that! He likes the motorcycle. Maybe just for that. But it's just some guy behind me. All right, where was I? You interrupt my story. Yeah, people don't usually know it's cool as fuck when they're chatting on me. All right. I'm really distracted now. Oh yeah, so new grapefruit's not. So we've had sex, we're gonna have sex, I don't know where she went. Word on the street is that she got in a fight and left, which is what I told her to do. I don't know where she is. And okay, so there's something the plebs have to understand. There's only one grapefruit. And she's looped in time. Looked into experiencing reality. She's trained for this kind of thing. She's built for bathysphere depth. She's a fucking trained goddamn fucking spurgeon. Because you fucking okay, more here than who raped me. Why can you talk to the man who raped your girlfriend? Easy. He's a fucking military genius. I got his fucking information out of him. He's fucking building a goddamn copy of the JFK boat. And he's cool. He didn't do it. I said, man, that guy, I don't talk to him. You talk to him. And then you and he are spurged out spaz lords who are in full-on fucking relapse. Like I said, right? And then the thing about being full-on fucking spaz and fucking relapse is that unless you're military class spy ass fucking. You don't fucking know how to heal the goddamn condition, do you? No, you don't, because you haven't read the fucking handbook. Fucking morons. Jeez, you fucking inbred redneck burglars think you fucking know anything just you chew up a girl with fucking dope and she turns into a goddamn angel. I'm gonna fuck her and this should be mine. Yay! Now I'm a spook lord. No! Here's fucking Deliverance Part 2. Holy fuck. Sorry, this is my Roy Scheider impression. I'm steering really. This fucking motorcycle goes pretty fucking fast. Right? And by the way, I want a new one. Somebody get the accountants working on that budget immediately. I want a new goddamn motorcycle. Because this is hot, but to drive it like this, I'm going to need like a team of three grease monkeys to fucking put her back together because I'm not running the car, but I'm riding a motorcycle that was fucking bought in 1989. What fucking year is it? 2024? So it's a 35-year-old motorcycle. I'm driving it with a goddamn Batman tumbler. It's not going to hold up. Holy shit, I'm right across the street from Pope John Paul II High School. That's cool. Wow. Dude, hey, kind of whore. Fuck you. What a bitch. Ah, it's like in the Matrix where the agents downloaded the people. Anyway, she was, I don't fucking know what she was doing, but she was trying to. And then I'm driving like a mad fucking monster through the streets of Lacey. I'm literally to get attention. I don't have a motorcycle endorsement. My fucking license is supposedly suspended, right? So I'm looking like a complete fucking freak. I'm not a complete fucking freak. I'm completely in control. I like riding my motorcycle like this. And it's an actual emergency. And I'm being followed. Yeah, there's Caesars behind me in a fucking SUV military truck that can fucking transform. I want the local cops to fucking get on his ass and keep him from fucking following me so close. Because these fuckers have no idea where the going. They're looking at fucking GMAP app. It says that I'm plotted out to go. I fucking know. I'm not following the goddamn map. I know where the fuck I'm going. I got off at an exit. They had no idea I was getting off there. They're spurred out fucking paranoid methods. They have no fucking on. They just know that I'm working their ass and they think they're fucked. And they are, because even if they don't go to prison, the whole goddamn world's gonna know that they're the fuckers who dropped the fucking koozie ball and created a fucking monster that's going to be fucking told. Generations of coma about the goddamn Hungarian panic. Hi. Hi, I'm Jack. It'll be too bad if this... I'm recording this, right? This is good shit. Yeah. Currently recording. I don't have any screaming into my fucking headset mic, which is... It's not bad, but I can tell it's not great. Right? Tish tink. Aw. Aw. Okay, so my best friend in the whole world has a mother who's worth the trouble. Okay, I mean, she ain't that bad. She's got a real bad sense of comic timing. Like, imagine Lucille Ball, who eats pony and doesn't suck dick and costs a whole shitload of money anyway, and has a 1 in 10 chance instantly killing you on her first initiative roll the day if she doesn't get her fucking Xanax. She's not in the fucking moods on a good day. Not in the least. Right? And especially not now, since I'm running out of shit to run the fucking open fucking mic screaming out all these fucking details. I'm in a college town. Trust me, they have scanners in this town. Right? Everything I'm saying is into my Bluetooth. Everybody can fucking hear me. Look, guys. Everybody can fucking hear me. Everybody. Like, I don't have to go through the tedious monotony of publishing. Every fucking clando in the 500-mile radius is fucking listening to shit. Because I'm obviously totally spurred. Something, and everybody who doesn't have their ass in a sling wants to know what the fuck is happening next. And I'm living blue thunder. I'm not in the sky, but I'm on the desk, and I'm literally flying down the goddamn freeway, 88 Dodger traffic on my fucking four-wheeled motorcycle with the fucking training wheels, and I'm getting away with it because I'm under a federal order of federal protection, and everybody's like, oh, well, we probably just better get his way since we took him for $900,000 and he's still not mad at us and he saw the case and we feel like idiots and he's still nice to us. That's what a paladin can do. Fuck you fuckers. Let me show you my humility, bitch. I'll suck your dick. Ugh. Alright, so I was gonna suggest to George that he play this on Coast sometime, maybe not tonight. But I obviously have to do some pretty heavy editing because, oh my god, I'm using bad curse words. Holy shit. Oh my god, how dare I? My entire family's been murdering the fucking, like, 800 dudes are working together on the fucking internet after fucking laughing and giggling about my dead fucking cat. But, Christ, heaven fucking forbid a man the word fuck on the radio. Yeah, believe me, your fucking priorities are severely out of whack, America. Anyway, and since I'm transparent and I'm not guilty of anything, literally I'm solving the case and doing all the fucking work for these guys. The cops are more than likely to be happy to wait until the end of the fucking Blues Brothers reboot to fucking slap any bracelets on me. So they're just following. Now, the people are mil-spec Deezer Spurglords who at any moment could be taken over by their evil karmic twin and start being like cannibalistic humanoid bone dweller chuggers. Like, fucked up. And I know all about this stuff because I'm a really good guesser. And I've been a cult researcher for 30 fucking years. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. I've seen this stuff before. I know how it goes on. I can't believe Jared Kushner was stupid enough to let this happen. However, considering what he was smart enough to do, I'm not really going to hold it against him. I can't really fault Ivanka's taste. She knows a good deal when she sees it. And then considering, have you seen her dad? Oh, Christ, he looks older than Bernie now. Holy shit. They hit the presidents with enough stress that they get older, and then they take away the ability. Like, look. President Trump has seen better days, okay? But he's still going to fucking win. He's still goddamn president, and he's still my president, okay? They're not going to take him out. He's living just so he can have the experience of knowing that I voted for him. I haven't voted for him yet, but he fucking wants my vote. That's for goddamn sure. All right, hang on a second. Let me switch my camera. Ugh.
All right, can you hear me, fucker? Whippoorwill. Let me see. Do a transcript? Oh, thank God, it's here. Okay, good. All this stuff is prime audio. Now, I'm going to go into a clando establishment and order some food, and I'm going to call the FBI in front of these people because I want witnesses and I want crowd noise. And this is word from on high is I better watch my fucking mouth, okay? Because this is a business establishment, and if I piss off the Chinese mama Santa runs this place, she's not going to be good for me, okay? Just because I'm right doesn't mean I get to insult the Chinese ancestors. I'm not high, but I sound like it, don't I? Yeah, they don't like that shit, and then I don't want to ruin their business, and I also don't want to tell, hey, it's a CIA feed shop here. Yeah, I don't want to do that. Yeah, it's not cool, right? It's not cool. Too fucking bad. It's not cool. It's not fucking hot either. Taylor Swift cheers on Travis Kelce. TSTK. Aww. Chiefs versus Ravens. Chiefs versus Ravens. And Redskins wasn't good, but that you can have the Chiefs fighting the Ravens. You don't even... We white people don't even know what the fuck you're fucking making fun of, do you? Holy shit. You fucking know nothing about the goddamn real world. Not a god-blessed fucking thing. Oh, fucking Christ. Okay, where was I? So I'm driving on the highway like Blue Thunder, like Roy Scheider. I don't have a Lyman Good. I don't have a, what's her, who's that? Oh, God, what a mouse. Anyway, I don't know where that woman is, but she'll do. Like, she's the next contestant on Hot Fruit in Your Ass coming up. And then I don't know if she was stuck with that nerdy fucking four-eyed Spurglord. I can see, like, she must have been pounding down the fucking hypnotic drugs to keep her in place and not lose her fucking mind. Because I haven't talked to that woman for a long time. And then they told her she had AIDS. She doesn't have AIDS. They told her that she couldn't have sex with me because somebody would die. Okay, well, if I don't have sex with her, a lot of people are going to fucking die. Okay, you feel me? So these dudes who have been filling her head with this nonsense, when she finds out who the fuck they are, she's going to fucking tear out their goddamn limbs and their eyes from their sockets, both. She's going to play fucking mix and match with these fucking dudes because they've been lying to... Shit, have you met her? They've been lying to Grapefruit Prime Actual for 3 fucking years about me. Yeah, she misses me, duh. Okay, so... I don't know where she at, but she's not on my motorcycle, and she's not calling me. She can't. The fucking phones are compromised. I can't get a call in, out. No. I'm on totes lockdown. Full spectrum dominance. That's what used to be a good website, full spectrum dominance. I don't know if it's still up, but it refers to the control of the military of the battle space. If somebody has your phone, the way my phones are had, no calls go in, no calls go out unless they're high, unless they go through a team. And the team, in the case of me... Oh, no pretty girls talk to me. And any pretty girls who do talk to me audibly are actually men using a vocoder. They replace everything. They duplicate everything. I have been isolated and sealed away for years. The only time I ever got out was when I fucking busted through with the help of a peculiar circumstance, when I found Grapefruit Alpha Prime Shaw on Facebook with her three spurgling buddies, and I made her fall in love with me on Facebook, which wasn't hard. She already loved me, and I'm awesome. And then I gave her the sweet hope of relief, and she got herself the delusional impression that I was going to be her little puppet slave, and she was going to use me to escape from her fucking company, fucking spurgone hole. No. You don't use me to escape, bitch. I rescue you, and you kiss me. That's how the fucking movie goes. Holy fuck! This women's lib and the fucking Algonquin Nation never should have gone along. This is a culture that fucking thrives on fucking rape, public rape and humiliation, in order to teach children the fucking rules of life and the tribe. They didn't need women's lib; they needed women's bib. Holy fuck! So, there's a lot I haven't told everybody about what's going on, and I'm damn proud of that because it's fucked up. Like, I could tell some jokes that would get me killed by the biker gang. Oh, I drove by a biker gang going to a funeral today. Or they were going to my house to fucking kill me or my neighbor. Because there was like, at least 150 of them. All lined up, all their lights, really bright on. And they were driving like you're doing a parade. And they didn't give a shit about me. I'm sure every goddamn biker gang on the planet knows who the fuck Jack Star is now. Especially now after this fucking Blue Thunder run. What a fucking great day this is. The bottom line here is everybody's going to be okay. Because I know what's going on. The cops have already checked me out. I mean, I have creds. I have authority. They're not going to get my way. If they do, I will fucking murder them. Because they don't have jurisdiction. So if they get in my way, they're breaking the law. And then I can kill them. That's the rules of Canley. I don't know if you know anything about blood feuds, but they can get pretty fucking serious, especially with the Algonquin Nation, who, among other things, have the formula for the invisibility potion, which, as you can imagine, is pretty fucking highly in demand. I mean, wouldn't you like to have an invisibility potion? Especially for your dick, because it's so huge, you don't want to fucking scare people. So you just sprinkle a spray bottle with the invisibility potion on it, and then you spray your dick, right? And then it disappears. And then it's so easy to rape women then when there's no dick, right? Maybe you didn't know that. Yeah, I didn't know it either. I'm not real into this rape shit. Okay, it's just not my fucking scene. Not in the least. And yeah, it's not cool. And some of the people that I know, they think it's the goddamn coolest thing ever. They watch fucking Deliverance on repeat slow mo. Not to masturbate, but to do a fucking play-by-play, and they got a fucking chalkboard with the X's and O's, and they're doing fucking football fucking schemes, just to, you know, how to do it a little better. So, I'm not overly exaggerating. Some people build up a taste for this rape shit. Woo, doggies! It didn't happen to me. I don't plan on getting raped enough to have it sink in. I got shields. Frankly, I'm an amazing kisser, so I don't need to worry about raping anybody or getting raped again, considering what happened to the last time. I might walk a little funny, but I have a changeling daughter, so fuck you. I mean, it's kind of worth it. Kinda. I would never have chosen to do all that, because the deal was, they were like, oh yeah, there's like a 1 in 75,000 chance you'll hatch a royal changeling. But other than that, you'll probably just like have a 8-foot tall lizard dude come out of your body and then eat you. Like the alien movies, that's not a joke. That shit happens. Hey, hello, how are you? I'm good. I'm going to talk into my phone while I'm going to get a drink. It's going to sound crazy. They're used to me. This is the store next to the place that I like to go. And then, you know, the whole fucking Black Op world knows me. Duh, they know me my whole fucking life. They knew me before I was born. Like, my name was fucking picked by committee. All this shit. No wonder my parents didn't tell me anything. I'd be embarrassed too. Oh my god. Speaking of embarrassed too, what happened to the guy who founded the Bang Company? Did they shoot him? Or did he just fucking kill himself in fucking disgrace? Like, how the fuck did he fumble that fucking deal? Well, here's a hint. He was gonna fumble it one way or another. Like, it just wasn't gonna happen. Build you up, buttercup, just to knock you down. I'm not going to sing right now. I'm kind of stoked. Did I mention New Grapefruit is hot? Hot as fuck. And she's not really a lot new. She looks like she's, late 40s, dumpy as fuck, you know. All cheesecloth and gator git. But that's just disguise, right? And then I happen to know, I know the secret. I know the secret for rejuvenating woman. You want to know what it is? You express real love for her and you fuck her a lot. That's all you gotta do. No, it's a wicked simple fucking formula, isn't it? Actually love them, fuck them senseless every night. It's amazing how well that works, right? So, I have done that before. I will do it again. And if I didn't have this other thing to do, I would not have left. I would not have left. I haven't seen Grapefruit in a while. Ooh, a Flame Boy beef patty with pepper jack cheese sandwich. I don't want that shit. But I'm hungry enough that I was looking at it for a minute. Oh, I hate this song. Oh God. Okay. I think I need cigarettes, but not really. I need something. Not alcohol. Oh, a stun gun. Fuck yeah. Do you got one of the ones you in Breaking Bad? I'm not kidding you. I need a stun gun. Yeah. Tactical stun gun, $59.99. High voltage, police grade. How good is it?
You don't know?
Dude.
Let me show you this one.
Okay. Oh, you got one. Have you had to use it?
You cannot use it.
Our conversation's privileged. I mean, nobody's gonna come after you. You're not admitting any liability. I'll have a disclaimer you can sign later. You can trust me. You know me. Do you have a cat you can use it on?
Yeah.
Is it a bad cat? Okay, then don't do it. What happens if you use it on me? Would I be paralyzed for a second or... Holy shit! Okay. That's $60?
You can do it.
How many times can you do that before it runs out of battery?
I don't know.
You don't know? Son, you don't have the kind...
I don't know how many times. Do you need it too many times?
Okay, so you exactly know and you still want to admit that you play with it all the time. Okay, that's fine. I want one. I'll bet. Yep. Sorry. It's one of those days. I'm not gonna carry a gun. I've already got the dick. And then I'm not really worried about anything, but it's gonna look real impressive to the crazed, paranoid, delusional drug addicts who are fucking following me around. They're all in full on relapse with this thing they're doing wrong. They're misusing military technology, and it's designed to make them go. And they don't know that because they're inbred redneck hillbilly fucks, and I read the books. So that's cool. And I'm not too worried, but God, it's been like 2.5 years. I'm real tired of not getting hugs. Yeah. Looks worth it. I'm gonna crack this open. I'm real thirsty. Hi. That's not for me. I was in jail for 4 days. They put me on a psychiatric hold, and then they found out that I'm fine. So they were kind of taken aback. I guess they were figured they were gonna shuffle me off to Buffalo, and well, it's a euphemism, the Western State. But there's no room in there for people who aren't crazy, and I'm fine. I like speaking quickly because when you're on the radio, they only give you so much time.
Yeah, I know. I understand what you're talking.
Yeah, and then the kids today can keep up with me. It is too damn fast. It's way too fast. I agree.
You still.
That's how I scare the old people. Can you take that out of the box for me? Thank you.
Take the off box?
Yeah, I don't need the box. No, I need that stick. What's this?
It doesn't have a charge battle, so.
Oh Jesus, how long does it take to charge? It's a good thing I got a power pack on my boat.
Okay.
Okay.
It doesn't charge it at all, so you'll feel
it.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I want it. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, I don't need it right now, right? Okay. I just need it for effect, and then I don't want to show him my super magic powers, so I'll have a stick. See you later, bro. Apologize for the disrespect. Thank you. All right, yeah, he's cool. I wouldn't act that way normally, and I was being a little rude bitch, but he happens to know. He knows who the fuck I am, and he knows what's happening. He doesn't know that I fucking figured out a whole bunch of shit, and I found fresh grapefruit today. Did I mention she's hot as fuck? Like, not any hotter than the last one, but that woman's dead. D-E-A-D dead. D-E-A. Well, bitch was D-E-A anyway, so she might as well be dead. Hey, hello. So she's gone. And then that woman, I thought she was just quirky. I didn't know she was, you know, fucking human fish hybrid or whatever the fuck. I mean, I like it. I'm cool. I'm into it. But I thought there was a normal girl under there. And there was. She's just a different one. But the actual asset that... Have fucked, will fucked, gonna fuck, wanna fuck. Yeah, that one. Yeah, she's not off duty ever.
She's a fucking force of nature to be fucking reckoned with. She's Pinky on the brain for now, right? And there's only one of her, but she's looped in time, so she's having all these experiences simultaneously, which for a woman her age is pretty impressive to do, right? She's 60,000 years old. Ugh. And doesn't that sound like bullshit? It's fucking not. Okay. She carries it well, right? And then I'm sure there's a lot of new grapefruits, right? I'm sure there's quite a few gals that I could walk up to and go, "Oh my God, it's a new grapefruit!" And then she would be once, especially once I started boinking her. But the one that I'm gonna, I figured that when the twat bearer was ready, the path to the fucking snatch the hatch would open up, and that's exactly what has happened. In fact. There's no possibility that I'm gonna lose. At the minimum, I'm gonna go and marry the one that's going to fucking Supermax for being a fucking what's the word I'm looking for? Chode toad. Fucking what a toddler. She thought she was gonna fucking pull a fast one on ye old Jackstar. She thought I was like, what? She thought I was stupid. And she's a brain-damaged California big-titted whore. She didn't start out that smart, okay? And then she's been brainwashed, and then she's been brainwashed badly. And on top of all that, she thought she was smarter than me and that I was really stupid. And she thought I couldn't fuck, and she thought I had a small dick. And she thought it was my job to get hard for her. And that it wasn't... She didn't want to deal with me unless I could get hard, and then she would deal with it. That's what she thought. So she thought I was a bad lover. Now, I don't know if they gave her this programming or if that's what she came up with on her own. But for 12 years, this bitch was... for 12 years, this kind, gentle woman was being used as a... clando-prostituted whore by a bunch of fucking morons who thought it'd be a good idea to do that for years. And I would have been happy to have done something about it, but nobody told me this was happening, and she never told me the truth. And I guess she was too afraid to let me know. And then they kept wiping her brain, and now she's... now she's toast-fucked. And, well, that's a special consequence you get for lying to clergy, let me tell you what. And then I'm sure something will happen to her that's nice. I'm going to go get new grapefruit. I'm going to get some hot piece of ass, like she's fucking crazy hot. And it's, the other one is too, right? But she's, I don't want to say broken, but let's just say uncorrupting her at this point would be unfair to the other broken ladies who need to also have personal attention. And I've been dealing with this one like nearly nonstop for like the whole fucking time, like 2.5 years. Like I get home, I get into an ambush. This woman pulls a knife, screams her name, and asks questions about my ass and her dick, or her dick and my ass. Like I want to know the fucking answers, and I'm just about done getting those answers, and I'm absolutely done having sex with that one, unless New Grapefruit wants me to, like, I don't know, put a pin in it or fuck her to death or something, right? Because New Grapefruit is, well, she's a more convincing liar, right? And then she's, like, really hot, right? And then she apparently isn't, an idiot. Which is good, right? She probably drops my IQ points when I get in the room, because I am, I am the hottest goddamn man to have ever lived at this point. Way, way, way hotter than Indiana Jones. Like beyond. Like I've actually done this shit that I'm talking about. Plus all this other stuff more. I'm not even gonna tell you about it. I'm busy. And then that sounds like fucking nonsense. I'm insane. Good, good, good. I don't know why don't people believe in it right now. I got enough fucking problems without people actually knowing what the fuck. Like, what's happening is fucking out the fucking door, out fucking rageous. Like, it's just fucking completely full on fucking nuts. And then, once again, I just reenacted Blue Thunder on the two-dimensional plane on the freeways, with bad guys following me in a black SUV as I exceeded the speed limit with a suspended license, but judging by my motorcycle endorsement. Do you hear me surrendering to these, admitting to these crimes? Yes, I confess, I did it. All this is inadmissible anyway, so fuck them. Right, none of this is working out for them. My why isn't this charging right?
Interesting. It doesn't work the way the man said it did. And then, is this gonna make noise? All right, well, fuck you. I don't care. It's plugged into the box. The guy who stole my box, he's in trouble, okay? Because what happened was he wasn't told, hey, steal the power supply. He just couldn't fucking help himself. I left it there, and he's a kleptomaniac. He couldn't possibly not take it. And he did a really good job. The guy's an expert thief. Not the only master thief I ever met, but I'm not going to lie, I was very impressed. And then the way he handled it afterwards was very professional. And I don't know if you know much about the thieving class, but they have a code of their own. And I'm not calling the man a friend, right? But let's just say nobody told him to steal that fucking power pack. And he really shouldn't have. And then I baited him with it, and he fell for it. And now he's in trouble, and I'm in a good position. Ah, we can play chess later. Maybe he can try to steal my queen. My God, I'm drinking. Full Throttle is the official energy drink of the Michael Kuzi Experience. You ever had Full Throttle? It's a hell of a brand. I think they only have two flavors, and they one's blue and one's not, right? Stun contact probes, LED flashlight. Oh, it's got a flashlight. Plug the charger into standard wall. Oh, insert the batteries. I have to go back and get batteries. You do put the batteries in? Motherfuck bucket. All right, well, he's probably not in trouble. Okay, so now I'm hoping that new grapefruit's new daughter is in here and is going to take my order. Because she's hot, too. But, like, the mother is way hotter. Hey, come in. Okay. So, probably not, but either way. Hey! Hi. Oh, thank God it's you. I need tempura appetizer and the shrimp tempura dinner together.
Alright. The appetizer with the veggies?
But yeah, okay, so basically the tempura dinner with three shrimps thrown on top. No, with veggies.
Okay, so just what the one meal, right?
Well,
prawn tempura that comes with the three on top and then the veggies.
Well, do you sell the prawns separate?
Yes.
Okay, then do that.
Yeah. So six total prawns. Three on the meal, three on the side.
Well, I don't want the meal then. I want the vegetable tempura meal. And then I want prawns on top. Just three. Unless I can get four. I don't know if you sell them.
Okay, well, so what you're describing to me is the prawn tempura meal because it comes with three and then has vegetable tempura also.
I think it's generous to say that I'm describing anything. Okay, let's start forward.
Okay.
It's a great day.
Yes.
Vegetable tempura meal.
Okay.
On top of that, three shrimp sticks.
Okay.
Well, are they prawns or are they shrimp?
They're prawns.
Dude, I found a place where they were selling pieces of special meat.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like...
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's a world. It's a strange world, okay? But that's not here. And I didn't order any. But I'm going to stick with the vegetable tempura, and I just want three prawns. Oh, yeah, you sell them three prawns. Right, so I can't get five.
No.
Okay, that makes sense.
If you get the prawn tempura, I could do a side of three prawns, and then you'll have six total with the vegetable tempura, though.
But thank you, we've established that.
Okay, okay.
I like
just making sure. Just making sure.
Yeah, I know. I've started blazing on you.
No, it's okay, it's okay.
Very unusual day. I got one.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna go.
For here, right?
No, better get it to go.
This one's to go? Okay.
I might have to flip out.
23.
I just bought a stun gun.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I never had one before. Have you?
I have not either.
I'm looking forward to it.
Where do you use it?
Just by buying it on my card that shows up in the database, and the guys who are watching me are like, what the fuck you buy one of them for?
I see.
I mean, I don't need one, but if I do, I know what the fuck.
Yeah.
It doesn't need a stun, man. I blaze a stunner.
Yeah.
And then, yeah.
Keep that.
Can't tell you exactly what I figured out, but you don't want to know anyway. It's cool shit, though.
This one's asking for a signature.
I'm changing my signature to X.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
We'll call 24 when that one's ready.
All right, thank you. I'll be in my usual spot. All right. And then I gotta go get the batteries. Excuse me. Come on.
I'm sorry?
I think I met your mom.
Oh, where?
Not sure. At a house in Kent.
I'm sorry?
At a house in Kent.
No.
Good. Good. Is there a place I can charge my phone here?
There's an outlet near
It's not too important.
There's one right over there.
Okay. I'll be right back. Thank Oh, I have to take that one. Okay. Did you hear all that? This is me freaking out the weight stuff. All right, I'm taking this one with me. Throw this away. We're good.
I have an assistant.
Definitely somebody's mother, though. She had that motherly look on her face. And then, I don't think that's necessarily the same one. I think it's a slightly different, like, eventual vortex thing. That place is the place where I met Y. And I don't know how many of you remember Y. It's important to remember Y. Probably very few of you do, unless you're guilty as fucking sin or anything. And then I don't think of Y often, but when I do think of Y, eventually I will think of X. Not in any particular hurry, sadly. But that was one hell of a night. Like, I walked into a restaurant through one of them fucking portal things that made it so that, like, it was legit like 11:30 at night. And I walk in, why is the place open? Why am I in a dimensional pocket? Why are they there? Why are they open? What the fuck? Why do they look like these people I know? Cause it's like when you're on the train station portal and never mind. I gotta do some commerce. Excuse me. I think I left the batteries. It says it comes with batteries. Did you, you didn't put them inside from the box, did you?
What are you talking about?
The instructions say insert the included 16 850 batteries into the unit. And I don't remember having that. Might be tiny batteries in the book. Yeah. Yeah, I'll check another one. Somewhere. The instructions say included batteries. Weird. Okay, well, that's fine. Go ahead. I've already bought. Thank you. Simplify. So that guy's a bruiser. He's been sent to make sure that nothing goes wrong. Nothing should go wrong. As I think I mentioned earlier, the good news is I know how to fix all these problems. The bad news is I'm in no position to actually do anything about it. I don't work for any federal agency. I work for my mom, who's dead. So, sure makes tax time a breeze, I'll tell you that. And then I'm not going to get a job with the FBI because I have class, right? But I have to call him and I have to tell him about this guy who's he's it's not that he's up to no good, but he's kind of like in a fugue state. Not like a real one, but he's not fully conscious of what he's doing. For one thing, he's really stiffening my balls. And you think that's a funny idea? It's not a goddamn funny idea. I'm gonna make him fucking twice as paralyzed as Christopher Reeve. I'm gonna breed his fucking daughters in front of him. I'm gonna roll his goddamn wheelchair up in front of the fucking monitor and put his whole fucking his whole fucking descended line on fucking OnlyFans and make me watch him fucking do the whole thing like a fucking whack-a-mole fucking fest. Not really, but in reality, the real guy, he's not his evil karmic twin self. He's a guy who's nice, right? But that guy's not there. When his higher self tries to manifest inside the body, it doesn't get to before the inverse quantumly linked evil twin karmic pair consciousness manifests out of borderline quasi-reality, and the person who he was before is replaced by the most evil version possible at that moment in time based on the conditions at hand. Just like in that Star Trek episode, Mirror, Mirror, it's the exact fucking same thing happens when they break the security system that the Navy built into these chemicals because they didn't want a gang of inbred racist hillbilly country redneck fucks to steal clandestine technology and use it against American people. They didn't want that to happen, so they planned ahead for that. And so now that it's happened, and all the instruction manuals have been burned. I forget when that happened, but it's something to do with war in Iraq. But somebody thought it'd be a bright idea to unclassify some technology, which made it possible for douchebags to sell it on the open black market in Bahrain and Dubai and other such places. And so now these fucktards are capable of whipping together a chemical compound that they inject into one of these women through two needle blasts in each arm, and it turns them into... Remember Kim Basinger in Blind Date? Imagine if that worked. And she doesn't completely lose control until you get like 500 feet away and push a button on the embedded remote in your knee. You know, rub around under the bone and feel a little click. And then all of a sudden the woman just like turns into Bette Midler on steroids. That's how it works. She like spins herself up like River Tam at the end and goes, "Wah!" They can do that. They got these chemicals to do it. And then when they abuse them, they don't work anymore. They don't work now, which is great. But the way that they don't work consists of... what's the word I'm looking for? Is that mine?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Chelsea. Thanks. The way that happens is that a lot of unexpected side effects occur that aren't particularly pleasant for anybody. I mean, I look back and it was fun, but... I was in shock the whole time, and for an hour and a half, this whirling dervish of a woman was throwing things at me and trying to kill me. That was Christmas 2021. And then since then, I haven't got any therapy. Oh, no. Oh, no, I've just been running around having like 800 to 900 of these dudes who are working in a stock team fucking blowing up my life with various clandestine tricks and means and shit. Chuck Schumer knows all about it. And the fact that I'm alive, that doesn't mean I'm Jack Hill or squat. Right, I'm only hanging on because I got to fucking chow on that box from that new grapefruit lady. I'm gonna eat that pussy for days. Okay, I'm not kidding. Days. You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Good luck. I'm gonna show Nicolas Cage a thing or two about peaches. Okay, I was going to call the FBI and record on this phone, but I'm going to wait till that one charges, and I'm hungry. And I think 43 minutes of this is enough for now. Don't you? Okay, bye.
Sorry for asking me to host here on the weekends. It has been my pleasure to hang out with you while you suffer your insomnia. Thanks for listening to Coast to Coast AM.
I decided to get making a big spread fest. Cusco. It's actually called Cusco. It's Funko, it's Cusco. Sadly, there's no Ditko. I don't know if you actually heard of the song, whether you... I don't know when it was hot and fresh. Now I remember when it's... what they still play. Like, this place is frozen in time. They don't do shit. They just swarmed out and bought it all, and then they killed them. Minimizing them. And this became this huge mass of... bleh. And then when I attempted to get people to pay attention to what was critical... I'm mostly kind of blown off, scoffed at, you know. Like you do. Hi, I'm Jack, I'm a star. People don't remember how long ago it was that people routinely gave me nothing but grief. But for me, it was just today. Like, I can't tell you how sensitive it is, but it's pretty sensitive. There's an ongoing development going on, and it's not going to be pretty for somebody. Somebody's going to be disappointed as fuck. Because they're not going to get something that they think is a slam dunk, all right? Because there's these two parallel future timelines that diverge from a single point. Essentially, there's these two broads that are vying for rivalry, and it wasn't that way before. There used to be this other thing going on, and then somebody changed that. None of this happened with my oversight. I was out of that loop. Partially because I chose to play Division for longer. Also partially because people were sick of me just being a retard video game player. Well, mysteriously, I was sick of that too. And rather than address that issue, the definition of sanity is doing the same thing, expecting different results. I don't know if I expected different results, but I knew what the result would be. Something would break. So when something broke, I wasn't too surprised. And as they continued to break, I wondered, you know, who would pick up these pieces in the past? Would there even be pieces? Wouldn't they just fix things as they broke and then not save them up to sabotage their weaker members of the tribe? It's a self-cannibalization. I'm not going to criticize. Okay, because it worked. I just got done listening to Major Ed Dames, who I talked some Spurg on before. I will talk Spurg on again. And he sounded kind of nervous. Kind of nervous for the old Major, which made sense because he didn't have anything prepared that was new. He was Spurging out shit I heard years before. And then that's fine with me. Fine with me. Because they're kind of totes fucked. A little bit, in a way. I mean, it's not real bad. I am their bound servant and protector. But they're not really... Oh, my post-visibility... They're not really on the ball the way they thought they were going to be. For one thing, I'm not in Western State Hospital. For another, I'm not insane. I kind of have a puerile sense of humor, and I'm kind of a boorish prick sometimes, but we all have our failings. I'm not going to pick out everybody else's. I just did mine for you. I probably have some more. And somebody else, I mean, they're on the run. What is that noise? Oh, I think that's an animal. Because I'm out in the actual woods. Down there where they got me, it's a lifeless fucking super fun site of fucking toxic exposure. Which is cool, right? It used to be they didn't know what to do. Ooh, space squids. Shut it down. Sacrifice a virgin. You know, they had no clue what to do. And they were sacrificing virgins anyway, so what the fuck. These days, they know what to do. Stand back and take notes on Jackstar. All right? I don't know why. Somebody had to. I was certainly capable of volunteering. It is fun. Right?
I said I was going to do it. I did do it. There were obstacles erected before me, and I blew through them. So I might as well just keep on going. I've made friends just by being myself. Nigger faggot.
My posse. Now I'm gonna tell you a story, a tale of wrong and right, and freedom is the reason. You can't take it without a fight. So now I'm starting up a posse to come and look for you. We're gonna put a stop to what you want to do. You fucking whore.
You fucking whore.
That's all you are. You say our records are offensive. Our messages ain't right. You say we're gonna label records so our kids can grow up right. You fucking whore. That's all you are.
Shit, fuck, say, death, sex, drug, rape. These 7 words you're trying to take. Shit, fuck, say, death, sex, drug, rape. Right or wrong, it's not choice to make. America, the beautiful land of the free. Don't use the words to land of democracy.
Remember when I said I was going to stop using the N-word and the F-word? Okay, I meant it. Now I'm using it ironically.
Nigga, faggot.
It's not a fun word. I think it's gross and disgusting. Nevertheless, these words have entered common parlance under certain niche fields of communication. And in those niche fields, there's a certain kind of lockdown corralling effect. And over the span of years, other people have controlled that effect. I don't need this fucking phone. I ain't tossing it in the sound. Be a bit of a waste of money, but what else is new? I have options. I don't know what the other people have. They didn't tell me the truth. They weren't honest about what their dealings were. Can't really help that. I saw somebody the other day. Not gonna say who. People say I talk too much. I don't. I talk as little as possible. I don't want to say a word. Before, I didn't want to say a word either, but because people were, you know, trying to kill me, I thought that not being killed was cool. And being the person that I am, the way that I was able to keep myself from being killed was to write and to speak. So yeah, I suppose that if somebody wanted the opposite of that, they'd want me to stop talking, and then they'd tell me to do, and then I guess they'd imagine that would work. I guess they lived in a world where they just got compliance before. Now I don't have to comply. When somebody's trying to kill you, evidently, they no longer have authority. It just vanishes in a puff of. I'm gonna be like Johnny Appleseed. I'm gonna teach law to the Native American peoples in a way that they can actually use. Since they're all functionally illiterate, screaming, raging, junkie alcoholics, I'm gonna figure out some sort of like Ebonics law for the chieftain crowd. I don't mean to be rude. I'm certainly well positioned to do so. I've already begun this. It's worked out so well so far. I'd like to do something else. And I will. I will do something else. For example, I'm not going to spend the night in a driveway again tomorrow night. It would be rude. I was already encouraged to mosey on already. I didn't mosey. I just sat here and created more disturbances in the flow of the space-time continuum. I like doing that. Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I also like hearing Major Ed Dames terrified. I like that too. I didn't listen to him because I was busy doing my own thing. And then my own thing consists of dudes watching me do it. I was able to confirm this through a variety of means in the past, and now it's just become part of my life. Oh yeah, that's what they're doing. I'm not out in the woods enough. I feel like there's a lot of life here. Other places there's a lot of death. Speaking of death, it's a weird place. It's a haunted graveyard. I can't keep living there with the mold the way it is, and then leaving the mold there. Somebody should go and check out the mold. Somebody should look and say, "Oh, look, here's evidence of attempted homicide." Somebody should file a case. Somebody should. I don't have any awareness of that. I don't give two fucking slimy fucks, honestly. The old me would have. New me, in the future, I'll care about that kind of thing once again. But for the time being, now that I got these bastards over a barrel, I don't really care about the fine details. The innovation that I made was to jump their own timeline. The Warren's kicking around for like a year plus. Police people who talk to me about them, they give me false information. They have a programmed agenda and an item of point by point misleading me so that they can harvest me later. That's what they do. They harvest people. All the good cops are long gone. This is what we got. We got police who harvest us. So once that's stipulated, it changes the calculus a little bit, doesn't it? A little bit. You ever made a man stripped naked and then handcuffed into a tree? Me neither. I don't think it'd be a good habit to get into. Sounds kind of risky and deviant. And personally, I don't want any more deviant habits.
always the word procrastination. And I don't really want to be putting up spurgy content that, you know, just generally makes me sound like I'm kind of a rolling, rambling madman. It's not what I wanted to go. Sure worked, though, right? And then, as far as I know, the ripple effect of all these, there's no other word for it, Spurg Lords. Now, Spurg is all the digital communication that gets manipulated through actual time travel as well as pretend time travel. Simulated time travel is not time travel, but when the Lord Mighty God moves you from one time to another, like picking up a piece on a game board, you notice. I don't have to justify my feelings and say, well, this is how I know. Nope, I was there, fuck you, I know. I'm put right where God wants me to be. I'd like it if my DJI Powerbank 1000 were where I was supposed to be, but an opportunist took it because he couldn't help himself. He was kleptoed out. Was pushed too far. And with the big tasty morsel just dangling in front of him that I put there, he ran out with it. Stylishly. Didn't bring it back. And then I had to charge my devices at a wedding. And I wasn't really invited to participate or know anything about it. And then at the same time, I guess a bunch of men came and kidnapped my friend. Well, couldn't happen to a nicer girl. Throughout this process, I've just been mostly just talking out my ass. That's Jackstar. That's me. I could have done something else, but instead I've chosen this way. And then the modification of that could have been handled by a number of agencies. Oh, no. Until recently, the only agency was an Angel of Death. I really am kind of inconvenient, little bitch. And then I really am going to leave a mark on certain, I don't want to say niche, but certain sectors of association with people. It's not going to come back from it. What's a good example? Well, I have talked to Linda. I don't know if you know Linda. She's lovely. I adore her. I haven't talked to her for a while because I kind of had to leave. There was a conflict of interest between somebody who was thinking they were getting away with something and me. And then, yeah, I'm sure they did get away with a lot of shit. I was there to keep her alive. If I just left and went and find somebody else to fuck up to cuddle with, they would have killed her sooner. She's a pain in the ass. And then killing her moves her spirit into another more easily controllable form, like another shell jar. And I didn't really care for that. I also didn't care for the notion that I'd be blamed. And then this the whole idea of killing people and recycling them, not like they're fucking plastics on the line that you remold. That's not what people are. It's not what the purpose of it is. It's meant to be. So whatever kind of system they had before, now they do it a little differently. I'm personally very self-satisfied with this. People have asked me, what am I doing when I run out of money? I said, I'm never going to run out of money. Now that I know what I know, I think we're doing fine. Who wants to know? Who wants to know about me? I want to know who thought that I wasn't going to take umbrage at stuff that I'd find out later. I haven't really. Not much point. But I can see why my feathers were rustled before. My guard was up. So I'm glad that's over. I feel like the alarm period has passed for me. Nobody's really sweating me. I don't wish to accelerate or make things worse. And in an abundance of caution, in order to protect ways and means, I've successfully made it so that they can't do anything further with this debacle. It's just going to be a scar on the landscape that they fucked up with. And then what's happened since, I still don't know. A few people have woken up and they've figured out that I'm not so bad. That's cool. Other than that, like big moves, don't really know. Saw a bunch of stuff close, saw a bunch of weird things. Saw, what did I see? I saw shit that a man shouldn't say. I saw the road where the dog tried to kill me before. Fucking dog did not like me. Dog ate my fucking teddy bear. Dog left chewed up eyes behind. Chewed up eyes were stolen by people who ransacked my house. This teddy bear and this dog has got a place in my heart for me.
I'm on the street where this dog used to yank my arm out of a socket. I bear that dog no ill will, but I don't miss her. Kind of hope she died painfully. No, not really, but fucking dog was a fucking wow. What a, I don't want to say a bitch, she wasn't, but the dog took a stern dislike to me. And then this other dog did that too. And then apparently the woman who got hauled off, well, the way I heard it elsewhere was that she got in a fight and then she stormed off with her partner. Now they're holed up somewhere in the wilderness, which is a brilliantly cute image. Like Laverne and Shirley thinking they're hiding underneath the fucking cloaking device. They're not getting away with fucking shit. I don't know what's going on, but I'm not looking at the Panopticon. I'm focused on what's before me, which is my itinerary. I got options. One of which is to sit one place in Yapsburg. It's not my favorite option, but it's something I can do, and no one can really follow me. There have been those who have tried to hurry me along, and in the past it has not worked out well. I'm hurried now. I'm not sure what else is doing. They all seem grateful that I'm not. I really do seem to be pretty unforgiving. I'm not mad at anybody and pretending. I'm not secretly harboring a grudge. I'm trying to hold in some giggles. What the fuck were some people thinking? I can't wait to find out. Every morning I kind of wake up with a song in my heart and a smile on my lips. Oh boy, we're gonna find out what these fucking dumb shits did again. It's not a great pleasure, but it is something to look forward to. It's not in jail. I went to jail and got analyzed. I figured that would happen at some point. I kind of forgot at the time, though. I set these things up in advance knowing that they'd be useful later. And when I wanted to go to custody, I arranged for that to happen. I did do it when they wanted to have their setup all ready to go. Ugh, they did shit to take advantage of my incarceration. It wasn't pretty. Some of these people were real vicious. And they will destroy a person's life at any given opportunity. They get charged out of it, and they get paid. That's how they live. Doesn't that sound like fun? Yeah, me too. I think I can avoid getting killed. I really don't have to talk about everything. I have no desire to overshare. Only sharing now because I'm not sure where to go and not cause any more trouble. I could cause so much trouble right now. I could. I don't wish to. I like being able to and thinking about it, but actually going through with it, not really my style. Of course, hanging out for 2.5 years while some corrupt institutions get their shit together wasn't really my style either, but now that I've done it, I think I'm going to make it part of my crest. I should probably call these lawyers and then tell them what I want them to do, because, I mean, they go through the motions, but until I can execute things, point at a star and say, turn the ship that way, it's not really official, even if I don't do anything. Even if I just sit there and grunt, the grunting has potent magical power. Which is awesome. Not going to joke about that. It's nothing like I really thought about when I was a stupid kid thinking, oh, I want to be a wizard. Kids, don't be a wizard. They're lame. And then it's not really possible to try to be a sorcerer. It's something you have to get a bunch of weird conditions to fall into play for. Basically, it's something that God gives to people when it's appropriate for that to happen. I don't really know. I talk a lot of shit. I don't really know. I don't. And I was not afforded opportunities to study what I wanted to study. Had to study other shit. Consequently, I'm pretty cranky. Right? Not the best of moods. Not a bad mood. It's really not. But when I think about what I got going on, I'm thinking, okay, why did it take so long to get here? Oh, yeah, because at one point they were trying to put me in jail for crimes that sound pretty bad. And then they went away and then they came back. Same situation, different names.
People, they're still doing it. There's still a cadre of Spurgler dickbags trying to choke out my life and my very, very ability to experience happiness. They want to silence it underneath a fucking cloud of fucking shit dust. Cool. I guess. I guess, you know, they call it clandestine because you're not supposed to be aware of it, but if it's an open struggle where they're splashing their magics against their fucking cloaks and shit, I don't know really what they do, but they do something. Definitely do something. And then I didn't get told anything because I wasn't supposed to survive this long. Every week they'd realize, he's still here, what do we do? You know, they did whatever they did. I was never really considered a permanent fixture, not for real. Their minds couldn't handle the possibility. What do you mean, a white man, do we get to have his foot? They got everybody else. Literally everybody else. I don't know if they're going to be afforded an opportunity to congregate again and then acquire new followers. I think the legend is going to spread. It's ugly. It's really ugly. Went to a man's house and asked about his companion, and he said she killed herself. And I was thinking, damn, she didn't call me up and suck my dick first. Damn, what a waste. I didn't really think that. I wasn't into her that way. But I definitely didn't hear about it. And then that guy didn't cotton to me. I didn't like his smarmy ways, and I didn't like the way he didn't trust me. I'm the one who's likely to be a problem. Oh no, I might talk too much. Or open a dimensional portal, or, you know, impregnate your daughter. Although apparently that hasn't happened. That, I don't know, do they all lie? Oh wait, they are women. I don't know. Kind of tired of asking questions that don't get answered. I'm not tired of sitting here in the dark, though. It's very dark. It's not too cold. I can hear the ocean. It's a nice feeling. I didn't know it'd be so nice here. I feel cozy and at home, slightly. There's still an undercurrent of tension because I am a filthy European nigger. But I'm a free, filthy Hungarian nigger. Counts for something. A lot of people aren't. I don't know what kind of obligations people have, but sometimes people have obligations. Not really my business. Business amounts to feeling self-conscious and shy. Not sure why. I did say a bunch of full-on fascist risque on the Twitter and on the Telegram, but a bunch of stupid fucking communication platforms that are all cancer. Vile, disgusting things. I share personal information with conscienceless reprobates. What do I get in exchange? Nothing. Noisemakers. Do you think I'm bipolar? Do you think I'm still blocked at Ali's panel? Oh yeah, of course. And what's the best way to address that? This could take weeks if not months. I didn't anticipate it would be so stubborn and spurgy, but I realized they have the best teacher, and I waited them out. They got nothing. They got double dismiss. Double dismiss. Because they can't sneak in the narrative for the next one.
What's the record state? With Mr. Guzzi, all of a sudden, within a span of 2 weeks, you're suddenly making contacts when you hadn't before, and you didn't actually talk to her. It was just an undercover person monitoring her phone, and then nobody knows why there was a falling out anyway. I'm sure there was a falling out. Haven't talked to anybody about it. Don't know who's been talking about it. It's been one of the most mishandled scenes of injustice that's ever been conceived. Kind of like it that way. Tell you the God's truth. I'm just not big on picking up after other people's mess. Sure, it has happened, but they come and they ransack on purpose. They come and they pillage in order to give the feeling superiority when they watch people try and clean up after them. Oh, that'll fuck over days because these people are sick in the head. Sick, sick, sick. Not the people here, whoever's here, but the people who are into that kind of thing. I think I can heal it all at once. It'll take some research, more research. And the general notion is that I find a balanced measurement on a number line of hacked marks. The single spot of invisible focus where everything is able to collapse in on itself and be more manageable. There's so many people here. Compared to where I was. Over there is nobody. Here, I think there's at least 8 or 9 families within earshot of me. They probably remember me. They're not really sociable, but again, neither am I. I don't get to go on ops. I don't get to find out what that's all about. I didn't make the commitment. I didn't do the training. I didn't take any steps whatsoever. But a lot more people have heard of weed now, and they're talking about shit they didn't talk about before. That feels like a good job to me. Payment might not be much. In fact, it isn't much. In fact, it's nothing. Huh? Payment being nothing.
You need to leave.
The Shirley Manson love fest continues.
That seems like an obvious design flaw.
Just
white, feather, feather black,
black,
castle,
beige,
prime,
beige,
tower,
tower,
Zugzwang,
Zugzwang, motherfucker.